Morning guys, in the theorem section now we will deal about reciprocity theorem. So already we deal about superposition theorem, Thevenin theorem, Norton's theorem, maximum power transfer theorem. So whatever we dealt, the theorems are way more important. They are applicable in different applications and all. Now reciprocity theorem is a theorem which is confined to few models only. So this theorem deal with only the response I here and the excitation, mainly the response and the excitation will be dealt here. So if the response here is taken I and the excitation which is given the voltage V, or else if we give the excitation current source current, we take the response here. So we take mainly the relations between excitation and the response only. So the reciprocity theorem states that in any branch of a network, the current I, so in this circuit we take different branches here. So in any branch of the circuit, the current response, so I took this branch for the response here. So in any branch of the network, current I due to a single source only, so only single source should be present in that network. That's the main thing we are dealing with the reciprocity theorem. Only single source of the voltage, so single source, the response you are taking I, so only single source should be present here, is equal to, so what is the equal to? The response of the current is equal to the current through the branch in which source was originally placed. So this response is equal to, where it is equal to? In the branch where the voltage source is initially placed. Now we are seeing the response in that voltage source branch. Now when this voltage source is replaced in the branch where the response is to be obtained. So this voltage source is replaced in the branch where the response is to be obtained, and the response is replaced where the source is present here. So this is called a reciprocal circuit of this circuit. This is original circuit and this is reciprocal circuit. So when we deal with the input voltage, this is the network, reciprocal network. So for the same network, this is T network. For the same network, if the input is current source, so how we will get the reciprocal circuit, we will deal. Now I am taking the input is current source, and the response here I will take the voltage across this branch. This is R4, this is R3, and this is R2, and this is R1, the current is I. So the reciprocal circuit of this circuit, original circuit, is we will replace this current source to a response branch in parallel with response branch. And I will share. We'll take in parallel. And this is the response here. This is R1. R2, R3, and this is R4. Right? When the current source is used, I replaced the current source with a targeted element in branch. Here the voltage source is replaced in series with the targeted element. Okay, so the current source is replaced in parallel with target element, and the response we need here, the response I need is voltage. So the response is placed where the source is initially present. So this is when voltage source is given, and this is when the current source is given. So if we observe these two reciprocal circuits, what I mean to clearly is, the main thing is have to keep in mind, while interchanging the response input and the response, we have to mainly consider the polarities. See, while I replace in interchanging this response, I took the terminals minus plus here. This is minus plus. So I'm not given plus minus here. The source is replaced with the targeted element should be ideally considered with the direction of this response. Since the direction of the response in downward direction, the source should be also in that direction that the represents the whatever the current through that source should be replaced, should be same as the response, as the direction of the response. So the direction of the response in downward direction, so in the current source also we have the downward direction, right? And here the input, the current will be delivered like this, so the response also should be like this. So both circuit, if we give the values, will get the response I similar. That's why the reciprocity theorem will be valid. If we have, if for these two circuits, if we calculate, the response will be equal. So if the responses are equal, then only the reciprocity theorem is valid. Okay, now coming to this circuit. So I took the current source in there, this direction. The voltage is represented here. So if you observe carefully, to replace this current source in the reciprocal circuit, I need to take the direction of this current source in downward direction here. Why? Because here the response in this direction. So you observe carefully, the current will flow through like this here. So that's why I took the current direction, downward direction. And the response voltage replacing this current source will be taken like this, since the current direction is in upward direction. So I think it is clear now. So this is about the reciprocity theorem. So we have the other definition of this reciprocity theorem. The reciprocity theorem is also defined as linear passive bilateral network. What linear passive bilateral network? This is linear. So this is linear circuit because we are having only resistors. We are not having any non-linear elements. What are the non-linear elements? That is diodes, transistors, these are all non-linear elements. So the other definition is, in any linear passive bilateral means two terminals, here the two terminals, bilateral network, excited by single source. So this network should be excited by a single source. Then the ratio of response to the excitation remains constant even if the position of source and load are interchanged. So in any linear bilateral network, excitation by a single source, so this is the bilateral linear passive bilateral network excited by a single source, the ratio of the response to the excitation remains constant even if the position of the source and load are interchanged. So even if the source, so the ratio, whatever you get the response, that means the indicates the response in both two circuits are equal. So for example, while considering the ratios here, what I'm saying, the ratio of the response to the excitation will be constant. So say this is a value of 1, V1, and this is the value of I1. So response we got, and here this is the value of V2 and this is the value of I1. So what we are doing, only we are interchanging the responses here. This is having a value of say about 5 volts. So, and there's a multiple of the 5 volts, say 2 into 5, this is 10 volts. So we get the response, I here some value I1, and this is a value I2. So the response means I1 by V1, response to the excitation is equal to I2 by V2. So here the ratios will be equal. If you are willing to prove that the ratios are equal, then only the reciprocity theorem is verified or proved. So we'll solve the different kinds of problems on based on this theorem, based on the circuits. So whatever the things we do, the main thing you have to concentrate is we have to interchange the excitation and the response based on the requirement. So in this theorem we have a few limitations here. So the first limitation have we seen is, so limitations means it is applicable to the circuit where it will be applied. So the first limitation is here, this theorem is valid for the network excited with a single source only. Network excited to single source. Only single source, if the excitation is done for the single source only, this network, this theorem is valid. And the theorem is valid if we do not have any dependent sources in the circuit. So we already have 4 dependent sources. So if any dependent sources present in the circuit, the reciprocity theorem is not valid. So these are the two limitations we have here, and it should be a linear bilateral network. This is also not applicable non-linear network. There is a third limitation, not applicable for non-linear element, non-linear network. So now coming to this is the limitations we have. So keeping in the mind of the three limitations, we have one important note in theorem. Important note. So when interchanging, this is the ideal voltage source, right? This is the ideal voltage source which is having internal resistance of 0 internal resistance in series. So the ideal voltage source must be connected in series with target branch. So contradiction of this is ideal current source. Must be connected in parallel with target branch. So this is the target branch, this is a normal branches we have. This current source should be replaced in parallel with the target branch. So while interchanging the source, these are the two important things we have to keep in mind. Okay, so ideal voltage source must be keep in parallel with the target, in series with the target branch. Ideal current source should keep in parallel with the target branch. Okay, now another important thing should keep in mind is the polarities. Polarity in changing, interchanging the response, interchanging the excitations. So while interchanging the excitation, we have to keep the polarities in mind. See here the response in the downward direction. So keeping in the mind of downward direction, the voltage source which is keeping in series with the target element should be in the such a way that should be intersynced with the response direction. So the source should be keeping in such a way that the response direction and the source output also in same direction. So if we keep in this direction, the response current will be in downward direction, similar to the response. Similarly, the response here should be in the same direction of the voltage source here. So what is the main thing here? In this this is the reciprocal circuit. So in the reciprocal circuit, the responses should be equal. So in the either circuit, the response should be equal. To get that response to be equal, the polarity should be in a certain way direction. The response is also in that direction. Okay, here the current direction we keep here. So this is the positive negative terminals. So the current will be drawn in a passive circuit like this, right here. So that's why the current direction in this direction. So for this current source, the voltage will be applied like this. So the response also will be kept like this. So here the voltage is the response, here the current in the response. So these two things has to be keep in mind while interchanging the polarities. That's the, if you interchange in different way, the response is not in that direction. So the reciprocity theorem is not valid there. So while I'll repeat again, the important things you have to keep while interchanging the response is that, interchanging the input is that, we have to keep in one main thing is the voltage source should be in series with the target branch, and the response is similar and the term polarities is similar to the response direction. Okay, and the current source should be in parallel with the target branch, and the polarity, the direction of this current source should be in the same direction of this passive. So these are the two important things we have to keep. The first thing is whether the voltage source should be parallel, should be in series with target branch. And current source should be in parallel. And we have to follow the terminals here. Right? So now, in next video, we solve two different problems based on the same concept here. Thank you.